Bienvenue to Le Café Craft. Okay, today we're doing part 9, the little flip-up bags. You're gonna need the bags, the scissors, the scalpel, other known as utility knife or Xacto, something with a blade, because we're gonna do surgery again. Ruler, because we got to measure a few things, even though we don't really care for it, we're just gonna have to do it. Edging kit, chipboard, or really heavy cardstock, or cereal box that, you know, you glue two layers of, or your file folders that you glue a few layers so it's thick enough. We get to that. We got everything. You're also gonna need whatever folder you use to do the fold out, the pop out, the pop up, the whatever you call it, the boards, what I call the boards. You're gonna need something like that, or cardstock. I think that's about that. Oh, you're gonna need little brads and, you know, a few little things, but nothing major. Okay, here we go. So we have this done, that done. And of course, because we were smart, we didn't glue anything. So we're taking this out of the way. So this way we can work. See, telling you, that was a good idea not to glue. We're gonna take our little bags and I'm gonna put on the side here. So first we're gonna need to do our side pocket. The side pocket is about half of your page. This page, the third page, this one here, here, that one, about half. There's several reasons for that. Number one reason is those little bags, either you cut them out in the paper of your choice, or you get them at Walmart like I did, they still are 3 inches wide. But you're gonna need something on the side to hold. Let me show you here. You're gonna need enough room for this to be able to hold little brads, which are gonna hold themselves, your little flip-up bags, because we don't call them flip-up for no reason at all. We call them flip-up because they do flip up. Yes. So you need some room to, you know, set that up. So based on, now, again, I don't know how many, what your measurements are and how many bags you're gonna put and all of that, but I'm pretty sure that in any case that, because see, I'm less than, what is it? Standard is 8.5 inches. I'm way less. I'm 6¾ and I'm 12 high. So even if you're not that high, what are you gonna put? Less bags, right? Let's put it this way. So you need to take this, which is the same thing than this. You can use nice cardstock if you got nice cardstock, or you can use the same than that, whatever you want to do with that. So it's going to be the same height than your board. The width in this specific case is going to be the 3 inches wide of the bag. Yes, yes. You're gonna have to leave something here. That's where the chipboard or heavy cardstock come in play. So we can put the brads on, and you get to leave some room here so you'll be able to fold. Talking about that, I hope you noticed in the previous video that those little pockets, folders, thingies need to have at least an eighth of an inch on both sides here, because this way you'll be able, see, don't forget, those things have to fold, right? So you don't want them to pop out and just like make your life miserable, which is also why you get to make sure you get enough room right here. See, that's the one that we didn't glue. You get to make sure you get enough room that you left in between the boards so they fold easily. But, you know, we said that so many times. All right, so you got this thing. So 3 inches is the bag, 4 inches is the side pocket. We're gonna leave a 1/4 inch on this side. Let me take the ear bang. 1/4 inch on this side and 3/4 inch, of course, Cher Watson, dear Watson, right? On the other side, because 3/4 plus 1/4 is a 1 full inch. And then you're gonna have to do visual. But first we do that. So hopefully this is straight. We're gonna do a quarter inch on this side, like so. And 3/4 inch, 1, 2, 3 on this side. Right. Same thing here. I mean, for somebody who doesn't like to measure, I measure a lot lately. Okay, 1/4 inch and 1, 2, 3, 3/4 inch on this side. And then we're gonna put, where was it? Right here. We're gonna trace a line. That's gonna be our guide for the bags. Where are you? Okay. So that's where you got, right. Now we're gonna leave that on the side for a second because we get to take care of the bags. So the bags, you get your little bags. So me, I'm gonna put 5 bags. I don't know how many bags you're gonna put. So I got my 5 bags somewhere and I figure I'm gonna alternate craft and white, right? Why not? So I need 2 craft and 2 white. 1 craft, 1 white, 1 white, 3 whites. Here's number 2. Okay. As I said in the scan that I sent for the bags, if you wanted to make them, right? You are gonna have to open the bottom of it like so, because we want them, it's just like for the envelope. This is why you want to have a fish knife, okay? You're gonna have to open them. Yes, you could cut them, but if you cut them, you know, you keep losing. This is gonna be too thick because there's a flap back here, and then if you cut, you just lose height and they're not that tall. So the easiest way to do it is to open them nicely. I mean, I just picked the bag, it's not gonna open, really? Here we go. All right, so all your bags are open, right? In the bottom part. Okay, so I have 3 white bag and 2 brown bag. Where's the other one which was open already? I know I had 1 brown bag open. Why is it like this all the time? No, I'm gonna open this one then. All right, now we're gonna take some strips of whatever, just, you know, those strips that we cut all the time that we have everywhere, those things, okay? We're gonna cut them 3 inches, a little bit than 3 inches. About, I don't know, between 3/4 and 1 inch. It doesn't really matter. I mean, you need enough, but you don't need. And this we're gonna put inside like so. Okay, and we're gonna line up with the other little flap. But when we do that, we're gonna put glue on it. Yes. So this way we're creating the other side of that little flap. I hope I make it just, you know what? Sometimes it's better to watch than to listen to this crazy woman telling us how to add a flap to a bag. All right, you don't need 1/2 gallon of glue either. It's pretty forward. All right, you insert in, you match about the other one, right? And now you have 2 flaps. Yes. Take another one, get about, I mean, I am not about to start measuring the up flaps. I am not, so I'm just gonna make sure it fits in. Don't make them too short. I mean, they don't make them tight, but don't make them too short because it's kind of defeat the purpose. All right, so that's good. Glue. Oh, please. Okay, and we're putting this in there. I mean, it's a little bit tedious, but it's not that bad. You line up with the other guy there, press it down, and that's 1. Did I do this one? 1, 2, 3. This one is already pre-cut. All right, now we are trucking along. All right, and now your little bags have 2 flaps. Yes, so you get to do those 2 guys. I mean, of course, I didn't put white paper because why Why would I do that? I mean, preferably whatever you're using, you know, try to kind of match with what you have, okay? And then this way, also you realize with that technique, whatever you're gonna put inside, right? Those are your bags. It's not gonna get glued on. You know, like sometimes you put things and you get caught up in the glue and you cannot take them out. Okay, if it's not even here, don't worry about it. We're gonna take care of that in about, I don't know. The time is gonna take me to do this one here. Oh, and I'm gonna talk about the giveaway for this week. Giveaway, okay, that fits. Glue. This glue is such a stupid night. I should have fixed that before I even started, but of course, I did not. Come here. Here. As they say in French, up, which is pretty much when you get, you know, done with something. Hop. Done. All right, so I'm about the same here. All right, now all your little bags have two flaps. You take your scissors and you kind of make your flap the same, right? So you cut that little angle here, there, one. This one is perfectly lined up, so I'm just gonna cut the little side here. Two. You know, that little angle thing. Three, that's good. Four. Get in there. Five. We got five bags. All right, so your bags are ready. That was not too hard, right? It's the same idea than for the envelope, except that the envelope, it was easier because both sides were the same. You know, I mean, you just had to flip both sides, but in this case with the bags, they only have one side. So then you're gonna fold the bottom part. Okay, you know what? Fold the right part, the one which was the existing flap, and then match on the other side, like so, right? Bone folder, bone folder. Okay, and repeat. You really have to try to stay straight, because otherwise, when you're gonna set up your bag, it's gonna get crooked. Can you see what I'm doing here? Okay, you get to line up the one that you add up, you get to line up on the other one, which is allegedly straight, because it comes from the factory. So, all right. Last one. Okay, so all your little bags pretty much can stand up now, right? I mean, not really, but if they wanted to, they could, right? So that's what we want, just like we did for the envelopes. Okay, we put those bags on the side. Okay, we get our little bags with the little add-on here. We have, in the scheme of all things, because I got to base myself on some type of measurement, right? This is gonna be my measurement, if you don't mind, because I'm doing it. So this is 4 inches wide. The bags are 3 inches. I have a quarter inch on this, on one side, and 3/4 inch on the other side. Then we're gonna say, we're gonna put the little bag. Now, how do we put the little bags? Well, the whole thing is, because I do not know how many bags you're having or how high your lapbook is, we're gonna do a visual. And visual is not that hard. Actually, it's way easier than measuring forever. Okay, so what you get to keep in mind is you're gonna keep a half inch in the bottom, right? So with a half inch in the bottom, and of course we don't want to go higher than the top. Yes, yes, obvious. So we're putting the first bag at the half inch mark. Then we're gonna put The second bang. Okay, hold on. Let me put it this way. Here we go. Half inch. Yeah, because you want to have that, you know, the little top flap against the board. So then you put, I mean, when I say visual, it's a visual. You pile up your little bags, right? One after the other. And then, of course, you don't want to go over the top. And then you see if you're about right, which means, you know, not one is like this and the other one is all the way up, right? Visually, about. We're not measuring yet, okay? And we say, well, you know, this one could go. Or no, the only thing is this one's got to be half inch. This one could be a little bit higher. And that's kind of look okay. I kind of look good, right? So what you do, that's when you take your ruler and you figure out how much, how high you went from your half inch to that first bag. In that specific case, I went from the half inch 1¾ inch, which means that if I put 1¾, I put a mark every 1¾, I should be able to get all my bags right. First bag is on the half inch mark. So half inch, we're gonna make, all right, I'm totally all the way out there, but that's the only way I can do it without putting my head over the camera. All right, so we got our half inch here. Yes, so we mark where we cross those two sidelines, right? And just like for the envelopes, we put a deep pencil mark. Okay, that is our first bag here, right there. Okay, the next one is about here, and that looks right to me because it looks like it's about the same, all of them. But let's see, as we go, we're gonna see if that works. Okay, so we say from this line here, which is a half inch from the bottom, we go 1¾. And we do 1¾. You know what? I can put it this way. Maybe it'd be so much easier for Patricia anyway. All right. 1¾. Okay. So from there, if I do 1¾, like so, and 1¾ here, like so, I can put my bags and see if I'm about right. So I got one here. Next one go to the second mark I made at 1¾. You know, you can cheat and pop it on the side, right? And then there's another mark here at 1¾, which is right there. And see, I mean, it kind of works, right? And the way we set them up to start with, nothing was going over the top. So in that specific case, 1¾ is a good measurement. But you have to do your own visual. And when you place them, just, you know, pop them on the side and then make a little mark and then figure out how far it is from the next one. And then chances are, you know, maybe a tenth of an inch is going to be about right. And then you take that even measurement, because we don't need to go, you know, bonkers. Same thing, if you, when you reach the top, it's maybe a little bit, okay, this one should go right here. If when you reach the top, it goes a little bit too high, you know, bring it down. Just don't drive yourself. I mean, nobody's gonna go and measure. As long as visually they're about, you know, space about the same, you're good, right? So 1¾. This is what we're doing. I mean, this is what I'm doing. 1¾ everywhere. And I know I measure on both sides because, you know what? Just never know. That's what I say. 1¾. I mean, if you have the same measurement than me, your life is great, isn't it? I mean, I know you guys, you know how to go around difficulties. It's like, if it doesn't work that way, well, we make it work a different way, that's all. That's what crafting is all about. Okay, so I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Is that my last bag here? I doubt it. No, one bag, two bags, three bags, four bags, five bags. Yep, that's my last bag right there. Okay, so now we do make those lines. Then we're gonna have to erase, okay? So there's one thing that you can do if you wanna make your life easier is to use a ledger cardstock paper or glue a piece of ledger, because in that case you only have to follow the lines, which let me tell you is a pretty cool thing to do. Okay, last one here. All right. Okay, so we do have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bags, right? So then now we operate. You ready? All right, watch your fingers. So just like we did for the envelope, okay? We're doing it extremely thin. Furthermore, then those bags are extremely thin, so don't make a big slice. Don't take a big slice out. I mean, really, just, okay? And just, you know, take your time. It's no rush. I mean, it's a piece of folder. I mean, if it doesn't work right, just take another one and do it again. See, I didn't go all the way to the end on this one. You really have to reach the line. Otherwise, you're gonna have a problem to put your bag in. All right, and again. And let's see what we got. Come on, you little hair of cardboard, cardstock. Here we go. Okay, don't pull, because you pull. All right, let's see how that works. Let's take this little bag. Insert the bag. Come on, you bag. All right, so just like we did for the envelope, we insert the bag, you flip it out, and here it is. And because you got those two lines, right, line it on your line so you know you're straight and in, for that matter. Okay, that looks pretty straight right there. Yes. Okay, and just like we did for the envelopes, right, we're gonna glue it one at the time, and we're gonna glue it in the position that we want them, which is folded toward the top. It's better to do it one at a time because, I mean, the envelope, there was only two of them, but you get five bags, and they're gonna keep flipping up and down, and they're not gonna be straight. You got those two lines, you know it's straight, it was on the two line, and then as much as you're gonna have time once the glue is on, you know, to make it better if you need to, if you get five of them, this is not gonna happen. Can take care of one, but not five at the same time anyway. Okay, done, you flip it. You check it's on the line. If it's not on the line, you put it back on the line. You have time to do that, right? You still have space here. You're good. Yes, yes. So repeat, 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 right? So maybe my editor-in-chief is just gonna speed up that whole part. Or maybe we do another one together. Really, almost sliced my finger right there. Okay. I'm telling you, when that Lapbook is gonna be done, man, we are gonna be singing. I will be, right? We're gonna have cause for celebration. Okay, I'm gonna put a little brown. Of course, you edge all your bags. You cover all your bags if you use the plain bags. You still can totally cover them. I mean, they're a lot easier to, you know, flip up and down if you glue them and then just make them look better later on. That's fine. It's not such a, because they're thin. So you insert your bag. There we go. You put it straight. That's straight. Maybe I didn't go enough on this side here. See, this is what I'm saying. You get to take your time. You get to do it right. No big Yeah. I mean, until it turned bad, and then I totally lose it. Come on now. See that? Yeah. Okay, hold on. I got to put it close to me because I cannot even see what I'm doing here. It's that little piece there which is bothering everybody. I mean, mostly me anyway. Let's see. Where is it? Where did he go? Here. No? Here. Yeah. Here. Come on, you. Yeah. See? So much better. Right? Right. Okay. So it is perfect. It flips. It's lined up. Flip it. Glue. I mean, it's not. It's a little bit tedious, but, you know, no more than that. I mean, this is not the part that they're going to do in 5 minutes flat. Well, if the glue doesn't come, that's just going to take way longer, too. So we don't care how that is. What we care is about how that is. And that is what? Perfect. Okay, take this. All right, number two, bag, 3 to go. Okay, now afterwards you get to, you know, take the pencil marks out and everything, but you know, of course you know that. All right, so we cannot put a bag in if we don't have that thing cut. Patricia, you get to cut first. Cutting. See, don't make the mistake I made. Go, make sure you go all the way to the line, not almost to the line. And you realize you really don't have to make it a big, you know, don't do a big gap because it's extremely thin. Pop this little guy out. All right, we're doing white. Oh, see, this one I did really well. I put it the wrong way. Fish knife. All right. So, yes, things happen. And what? It is not the end of the world. All right, we're taking this guy out because we need the little opening to be in the front. And this one is the wrong way too. Great. All right, so we're doing that again, like so. This one's got to go out, 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 out. Now, by now you understand why you need to have a fish knife, right? Because I don't know anything else which can do that. Other than a fish knife. Can try, but fish knife will do it every time. All right, see, I didn't cry. I didn't go, oh my God, life is horrible. I didn't, I just took it out, put it back, doing and undoing. Okay, here, here. All right, now, same thing. Line it up, that's good. It's good. Turning it around, taking the old glue out. I'm telling you something, I'm not even gonna take that out of that video because I know how everybody is just like, you know, you do everything perfect. No, we don't. We just mess it up one step at a time, just like you. But it's important to see that this is not about to stop us. All right, we are re-gluing. This one is like, I can glue myself all by myself. Okay, well, good for you. Look at that, you know, cooperating nicely. Okay, we good. So now this one goes here. Okay, you're gonna have to line up. Double checking. Take at that, it just re-glued itself. This is so amazing. I'm still gonna put a little bit more glue here. Okay, crisis averted. We are good. All right, that's number two. Number three. All right, now this time we are totally paying attention. We're putting the front in the front, right? Right, so we don't have to do everything twice. We are in, we are in, we are in. Lined up, flip, glue, glue. Glue. We good. All right. Fish knife. Well, hopefully we don't need you again. We hope. Okay. We're making this here. Right there. Cutting. See, if you do one at a time, right? When you glue it, I mean, the glue is not gonna dry right away. You have time to flip it back up and then put it exactly the way you want it. And this way, it's all good. Okay, now we're doing, this is the right way, yes. Now, if you want to if you want to put stamps or things like that on your bags, well, you know, do that before you put them in. But you know, they're really thin and light, so it's not really a big deal to decorate them once they're on. I mean, it's the envelope's a little bit. Well, first of all, because the envelope, maybe you want to add up, I don't know, you know, brads, pockets, this, that. Those are pretty much forward. You know, it's like, that's it. It's the old bags. You're going to stash stuff in it. So that's what you do with the old bags. Okay, so this one here. And then we should have one more to go. All right, see, you still got time to move it. All right, and last one right here. And then you're done, Rami, kind of done with that. You're just gonna have to put that little thing on the side. Actually, I got a funny story going with that. So I was looking for a piece of chipboard, something thick, right, to put on the side here. And I just couldn't find, I mean, I got stuff, but I wanted, as usual, you know, it's too easy, it's right there. Let's find something different that I don't have, or look for it for an hour and a half, which is about what happened, really. But I found, and it's kind of funny, I found that piece of chipboard, which is, okay, come on, what happened here? Okay, we don't care, this is the back. All right, let me finish this, and then I'm going to get on with my chipboard story, because that's pretty cool. All right, last little bag, put it in. See, get to double check yourself. I didn't cut this one. You do have to do those little angle, otherwise it's not gonna get in. Now, of course, you're gonna cover the bags, right? Because as you notice, you have the, because we kind of keeping the back in the front, actually, right? So what we did here, there's a little mark. We're lining up. Is it lined up? Yes. Flipping it up. And then this one, of course, is a little bit, okay, let's adjust this because I don't want it popping out. So we're going to take a sliver out. Good, good. All right, so let's line up again. Lining it up. Flipping, gluing. So anyway, I was looking for that cheap board. You can use the, because that's what I used in the other, the super duper Lapbook. I used those Tim Horse cheap boards. Thing I'm gonna show you. Let me finish this because I'm about done with that at this point. Done, done, done. Is it? Is it? Yes. Okay, get the bags. All right, I used, you know, those chipboard, the Tim Horse collection, those things, right? You know, that type of thing. There's plenty. I mean, if you have those, go right ahead, use those. That's perfect. But I figure I wanted to do something. Of course, I wanted to do something different. So I figure, well, what am I gonna do? I got to find chipboard. I don't have chipboard. And then I found, because what do? I keep everything, right? I found that thing, which was the holding part of a pair of slippers. See, it says slippers, right? And I thought, oh, this is so cool. It's got holes and everything. So I took that. So, as I said, several boxes, and you know, you just double it so it's kind of thicker. The reason is this is gonna go here. Right, this is how I'm gonna do it. This is gonna go here. Now, you are gonna put stuff in those bags, right? So they're gonna be thicker. So you don't wanna put something here, which is gonna be like pressing it on, you know, to give it room to breathe. Room to breathe. So I thought I put this here, and then I got to use. Because this is how that works. If you hold the first bag in place, it will hold the second bag at the same time. And if you hold the third bag here, it will hold this one and that one. You see? So you need two spots to hold your bags, right? Right. I mean, of course, if your book is that big, and you get three bags. Oh, I don't even know how that will work. I think you would still need two, but I don't know. Maybe, you know, you come up with a better idea. I don't know. I have five bags. I got to hold five bags. Okay. So before anything, and before you forget, right. So, I mean, I'm sorry I'm doing that right now because I'm the best at forgetting to erase. And then I go, oh no, I have pencil marks everywhere. Okay, all that is gone, done. Whew. All right, now this is gonna go here, like so. And then I'm gonna put little brand, and then I'm gonna need a little something. Okay, so. If I go here, like this, I need to hold number three bag. So I need something here, and I need to hold number one bag. So I'm gonna need something here. Now I'm gonna need, all right, this is when all those little stupid little cutout that I do with everything there is, right? You know, those little square from top of pads. So I got all those things and I double them, and they're pretty thick. But I think I have some, oh, your music thing. That's cool. That is cool. Do I have another one? Come on. Yes. How about that? How about some music? How about we sing something? I'm singing all day. 500 subscriber. Are you kidding me? I'm just gonna wake up in the morning, la da la da da, like that, right? And everybody's gonna run away because I'm so off tune. See, I can put one like this and one like that, and my little bags are not gonna move. How cool is this? Really cool. Now, if you get a piece of chipboard or those things or whatever you're using, right? Because I mean, I'm not gonna tell you go buy slippers and keep them. You can use also, which is pretty thick, is the sides of shoe boxes. They're usually pretty thick, and some shoe boxes are actually really sturdy. So you can totally use that. So you can do two of them, like we did like it's on the original, or you can do one long one, you know, whatever. I figure, oh, I'm gonna do a little bit different. I'm gonna do one long one. So this will go here, and then you punch a hole where you need it, right? In this case, the holes were already punched, so that was all good. And then put a little brads. We need brads now. Okay, we're done with the cutting. We put the scalpel away. I got two type of little brads, which are like different than the other brads. I got this. That's pretty cool. It's got a little thing that you can, oh, maybe that's cool. And I have a little dragonfly. That's a pretty cool too. I don't know. Let's see. Let's see. Well, pretty much you're done with this. There's a few. Oh, there's another thing we get to address though with the back of the side pocket. See, so now if I put it here, this is gonna hold here, and there's gonna be stuff in it, right? Why is it that I never have stuff when I need stuff? Okay, so let's say we put a whole bunch of stuff in here, like so. Right now, this is good. And see what I'm saying? It's gonna hold it, because if you put it too tight, then you're never gonna be able to put anything in those pockets, and that will hold it, and that will hold this one, which will in return hold that one. And this one here, I'm gonna put here, because you can put it more this way if you want to. But see what I'm trying to say is, if it's thick, if you get a whole bunch of stuff, right? It's not gonna crush it. It's just gonna work fine. So right here, I kind of like those, because you can hook a little something on it. Do I have to? Yes. Oh my gosh. I mean, you can use regular brads. This is just like, I figure, oh, why don't I go fancy? Right. So in here, goes in there. All right, here it is. Okay, so just figure out where your brad should be for the little, I don't know, what do you call that? Tab, I guess. Tab is gonna go. You punch your hole, you put your tab with it, and then before you glue, just make sure it goes on the right spot. Or maybe you can see what I mean. You can, oh, maybe we can slice it higher. Slide it, not slice it. Okay, now, because this is a side pocket, you're gonna put things in. Yes, so maybe you wanna put a, anything actually for that matter, hold on. Something to cover in the back, so whatever you slide in doesn't hit on those things. Do you know what? I doubt very much that it does. We can always try. Let's see. Let's take pages of something. I think my board is not. There it goes, fine. So, I mean, if you want to make sure, right, and put you know what, you get packaging tape, put some on top of it so it's nice and smooth. I'll put one length of, I don't know, any paper for them. This one is not long enough. I mean, there's no point in making I need a long paper, right, like a full piece that way, so this way it's nice and smooth, and then you can slide things in there. Is there anything I should add? Yes. What I'm gonna add is, just like we did for everything else, do not glue it on, okay? Because, all right, this is the thing here. This is called a deconstructed Lapbook, right? So it is deconstructed and we are reconstructed it. Anyway, so you take your time to find your background, which is gonna have to go here. You gotta put this side pocket on the top. Maybe you had a nice piece of cardstock here. Take the time to decorate your bags, put some stamps, if you want to put stamps on them, or what did I do on the other one? I put little maps or whatever, you know, whatever you want to do, right? Decorate your stuff. And then when that's all done, you can totally glue that. If you know exactly where you're going to put it and this is going to hold exactly right where you want it, good. Then glue it. But do not glue this to your board. And the reason is, next time we're doing the deep pocket folders. There's one on each side, and we got to make sure that we can actually, you know, place them properly, glue them properly, all right? And when that's done, because the folders, once they're done, they're gonna be flat. There's no things popping up, right? So that's gonna be flat, which means you're gonna be able to fold that nice and smooth. And then when we're gonna assemble the whole thing, that's where we're gonna glue all the stuff we have. This. So take the time now to decorate whatever you want to decorate, the envelopes, the front of those cards, your bags, your side pocket, whatever you want to do with it. Get all that like really nice the way you want it. And then this way, because there's no way you're going to be able, when everything is going to be put down, you're not going to be able to do it, because it's not, you're not going to be able to stamp. There's going to be something in the back, whatever, you know how those things work, right? So we're not gluing. Furthermore, then this is going to have to be glued on the back cover, right? So we don't want to have like a million of things that if we're going to press, it's going to press things down. You know, this is not right. Okay. So that's that. So we're done with this, which was part 9. And then next time it's part 10, I think, at this point, which is going to be the file folder giveaway. Okay. I found in my stash of stuff, I have little money envelope from 1941 and 1940. And those were payroll envelope because they were getting cash, right? So those are pretty cool. And they are French. So I think that's pretty nice. So I'm going to scan them. So of course, you know what you can do with it, right? You can add up on the side and then, you know, fold the back and have yourself a little money envelope. So there's two of them. That's when you make a lot of money. That's when you don't make that much. Anyway, all right. So big money envelope, the small money envelope. Also, because the end of the year is coming soon, I have old French postcard. This one is saying Happy New Year. This one is saying Happy New Year too. That's a little note from a restaurant. Hotel Restaurant du Cheval Noir, the Black Horse. Woo. And the address was in front of the railway station. That's the address, in front of the railway station. Anyway, so here, and this one is a Happy Easter card, Joyeux Pâques. What I'm going to do, because I didn't do that last time, I'm also going to scan the back of them. So if you want to match them, you'll be able to match them. It's nicely written, and it's all in French. And this is, you know, this is cool. So that's going to be the giveaway. Cool. Okay, I hope you got that. And I hope you understand that this is your lab book. You're going to decorate the way you want to decorate it, right? Take your time to do it. You know, think about what you want to put here, there. You got your whole setup is done. Your little flip up bags are flipping up. And that's all that matters. Yes. Please subscribe. If you don't know how to go about for the giveaway, it's in the description box below. If you're still unsure, go to the little video called Intermission, because it does explain everything. And that's about that. Happy crafting, happy making, happy flipping of bags. Bye.